Hey everybody, it's Nate and Steph from Explorers.life. We teach people how to build DIY campers. Welcome back to episode number 24 in our Ford Transit Camper Van build series.
In our last episode, we installed a roof rack, and in this episode, we're gonna be installing solar panels. So let's get started.
The goal here was to maximize the amount of solar panels and wattage that we could fit onto our transit. Now we have a few different sizes here. And if you stick around to the end of the video, I'm gonna talk about some of the stats and specs of these panels and how it works whenever these three different types of panels are in the same solar array. These panels are all from Rich Solar. This one is a 200 watt. This one is a 55 watt. And these ones are 35 watts. And this 200 watt panel from Rich Solar has been on the market for quite a while, and it's been kind of my go-to for a panel that gets mounted side to side on a van roof. It just fits really, really nicely. And these two I'm particularly excited about because they're brand new to the market. We asked Rich Solar if they would be interested in making custom sized panels for our van, sure, but ultimately so that you guys could also have these same panels for the same functionality that we're having on our van. So these will be available to purchase. And the idea behind them is to have the 200 watt panels laterally and then have this panel here with a max air fan and then this panel on the other side as well. And then same thing with the air conditioner, panel, air conditioner, panel. So everything is nice, sleek, compact, and we can really utilize every single square foot on our van roof. So these Rich Solar panels, I'm really excited about them. Been talking to them for months at this point. It's awesome to have them in hand, but I'm more excited to actually get the cross braces on there so we can get them pre-wired and get them on the roof. The Unaka roof rack comes with some spacers to put between the cross braces and the solar panels to lift them up so that they fit flush with the top of the roof rack. The bolts connecting the solar panels to the cross braces get anti-seize applied to them before tightening them to an appropriate torque. Then we measured from the ends of the panels to the ends of the cross braces on each end to make sure that the panels were centered. For the panels that don't go all the way across, like the 55s and the 35s, I have the 55s here, for example, the cross braces, they have a cutout here. And that's by design because whenever we designed this, the clearance between the fan and the air conditioner was pretty small. We made that as small as we could so that we could fit as much solar as we possibly could on there. So that meant that there wasn't enough room to have a bottom one here. So as you're kind of handling these, they flex a little bit, but that's okay. It's kind of how we made it. And you're just going to be able to see that come together and why that's important once we actually get this stuff up on the roof. Now we have the solar panels mounted to the cross rails. And it's starting to take shape, and which is pretty exciting to kind of see like the vision come to life. So for these, we have the 200 watt panels up front, and these two panels are gonna be wired in series. Behind that, we have the two 55 watt panels, and we're gonna have the max air fan is right here. These two panels are going to be wired in series. And then lastly, we have this 35 watt panel and this 35 watt panel, and the pneumatic air conditioner is going to live right here. And these two panels are going to be wired in series. So like solar panels are going to be wired in series with these three series strings wired in parallel going to our solar isolator. And that's roughly how this is going to work. And here is a diagram so you can kind of see on paper because I'm about to do the wiring, but it's probably going to get a little messy. Now for the crossbars, you know, these get full angles. And like I said earlier, these are cut out. And you can kind of see that we have pretty low clearance between the fan and the air conditioner, which is why this doesn't have a full angle on the bottom there. And so this is doubled up and this piece adds stability to this part, which would ultimately be floating. Same with right here. So just lots of extra support to keep this lightweight, but also pretty rigid once it gets all bolted in place. Now I'm going to do the wiring for this array. I'm going to do as much of it on the ground as I can, make any jumpers that I need, so that whenever we move this all up to the roof, I'm having to spend less time on the ladder. Now I've made a video that shows you how to crimp and make new MC4 connectors and solar wires for jumpers and extensions in a separate video. And that's linked in the top right corner of your screen right now, as well as in the video description. Now is also the time to let you know that we have this entire array from the panels to the connectors to the wires available for sale through shop.explorus.life. We also have the roof rack available for sale through Unaka Gear Co. Information for both of these can be found in the video description below. The wires are secured to the bottoms of the solar panels with zip ties, so they are nice and protected from weather and the sun, even though the wire we're using is specifically designed to be exposed to the elements. So day two of this install, worked half a day on it yesterday, installing the cross rails to the solar panels, as well as doing all the pre-wiring on the ground, which I strongly recommend getting all of this stuff cleaned up nice and tidy. Now I want to talk about how this array is actually wired. So kind of as we mentioned earlier, it's a series parallel array configuration with our like panels in series strings and all those series strings in parallel. So positives and negatives of neighboring solar panels here are wired together, creating a series string. Then the positive and negative of this series string is coming down here to our MC4 combiners on this end. For the next series string is our 55 watt panels, positives and negatives of like panels wired together with the series string positives and negatives coming over here to the MC4 branch connector to wire in parallel with the previous series string. And lastly, the final 35 watt panels, positives and negatives are wired together with the positives and negatives of the series string coming over here and wiring to the MC4 combiners. Each of the positive wires gets a fuse, and we'll be talking about fuse sizing as well as array efficiency of a mixed solar array at the end of this video, because it's going to get kind of math heavy and I don't have it memorized. But what we need to do now is we need to move all this stuff up to the roof. I've already installed the roof entry gland, and so now it's time to get on some ladders and actually put this stuff up on the roof.
I'll hand it to you.
Two ladders are key for putting these panels on the roof. I handed the panels up to Eric, and he handed them across to me on the other side of the van, and they simply sit in place on top of the 80-20 side rails.
Got it.
Using the piece of styrofoam from the solar panel box was really helpful for getting the solar panels across the roof without scratching anything. Since we had to disconnect a few select MC4 connectors to move the panels to the roof, we had to reconnect those and put on a few additional zip ties. A few 8-inch sections of scrap 1x4 wedged into the side rails to tilt the panels up made easy work with this. Lastly, we connected the MC4 combiners to the MC4 connectors that are connected to the wires going through the roof that would eventually get connected to the solar isolator and charge controller. Connecting these wires at this time makes the array live, so covering the other ends of these wires as well as covering the array with cardboard to keep the voltage down is important, or you can simply leave these connections disconnected for now until the array is connected to the isolator. The final step is simply securing the cross braces to the 80-20 side rails with the cross brace hardware and T-nuts that we already slid into the 80-20. These bolts got blue Loctite applied to them before tightening. Now that the array is installed, let's go over the math of how this array of mismatched panels operates. Here is how our solar panels are arranged on the roof. We have two 200 watt panels operating at 20.4 volts and 9.8 amps, two 55 watt panels operating at 18.7 volts and 2.96 amps, and two 35 watt panels operating at 17.9 volts and 1.96 amps. The 200 watt panels are wired in series, and matched panels wired in series get their voltages added together while their amperages remain the same, which gives us a 400 watt series string operating at 40.8 volts and 9.8 amps. The 55 watt panels are wired in series, and matched solar panels wired in series get their voltages added together while their amperages remain the same, which gives us a 110 watt series string operating at 37.4 volts and 2.96 amps. The 35 watt panels are wired in series, and matched solar panels wired in series get their voltages added together while their amperages remain the same, which gives us a 70 watt series string operating at 35.8 volts and 1.96 amps. Those three series strings are wired in parallel with all of their positives and negatives going to 3-to-1 MC4 combiners. Mismatched series strings of solar panels wired in parallel get their amperages added together while their voltages operate at the lowest available series string voltage, which gives us an array operating at 35.8 volts and 14.72 amps. And using Watt's law of watts equals volts times amps, we can see that 35.8 volts times 14.72 amps is 527 watts. Now, since we installed 580 watts of solar panels and are seeing a theoretical on paper output of 527 watts, we are sitting at almost 91% array efficiency. Now, the only way to get 100% array efficiency here would be to run each series string to its own charge controller, which is absolutely doable, but is more wire than I wanted to run and more charge controllers than I wanted to use in this system. For solar array fusing, using the same math as before, we have an array short circuit amperage of 2.13 amps plus 3.23 amps plus 10.2 amps, which gives us an array short circuit current of 15.56 amps. And since our solar array short circuit current is greater than our max series fuse rating of our panels, or at least two out of the three sizes, we will be putting MC4 fuses on the positive MC4 combiner, protecting the positive wires going to each series string. Now, technically we don't need a fuse on the wire going to the 200 watt series string, since its max series fuse rating is greater than the array short circuit amperage. But since the other two need fusing, I didn't want this one to feel left out, so it's getting one. We've got 10 amp fuses for the 55 and 35 watt series strings, and a 20 amp fuse for the 200 watt series string. Now, we are incredibly happy with how this turned out, and after our recent trip 1600 miles across the country to Idaho, the roof rack and solar panels were incredibly quiet and didn't appear to negatively affect fuel mileage much at all. We are super excited to finally have the solution to be able to put solar panels on the sides of a MaxAir fan and air conditioner, matching widths with a larger solar panel, which up until now hasn't really existed. Special thanks again to Rich Solar and Unaka Gear Co. for believing in the idea that we had and helping us bring it to life. Now, if you want the same roof rack and solar array setup as us, that would be awesome, and we have all of the information to help you do just that in the video description below. And that wraps up this video. We now have our solar panels wired into a solar array and fastened to our roof rack.
Now, if you're not sure how we got to this point in the build, tap below to binge watch our entire build playlist.
And if you are all caught up, tap here to watch the next video in the series, where we are going to be installing floors on the inside of the camper van. See you next time.